Wesley, get over here now.
Yo, Wesley! Oh, Wesley! Oh, Wesley, what the hell's going on? Oh, Wesley, why the hell did I have to come all the way over here for you to tell me something? You don't mean it.
She called.
Oh my god. Wait. Okay, before you say anything, what exactly did she say?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Look, I came home and I saw the phone buzzing, alright?
Oh my god. Oh my god, this isn't happening.
Look, it's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. As soon as we listen to that voicemail, that's when we'll know whether or not we... Wesley! Wesley!
Wesley!
What are you doing with my stuff? You know we can't run from this.
Don't care. I'm leaving. Either help me out or come up with a solution that doesn't end with the both of us in body bags!
Wesley! Wesley!
Stop! Think about this.
Look at all this. Everything will be gone in the blink of an eye. Everything, our entire lives. But what? Listen, we need to listen to that message. That message is our fate. And if you go now, there's no coming back.
Goodbye, we say.
Wes, wait. Wes, what are you doing? Wes, listen to me. You cannot leave. Wes, don't leave. Wes, stop. Wesley?
Hello. As you know, this is Dr. Colbert. What I'm about to tell you now...
Yeah, Dr. Colbert. It's Wesley. Wesley got away.
I understand. I know how important this is.
He took all my stuff and... No, we... What do you mean, dead or alive? It doesn't call for that. This doesn't call for that. Look, it's fine. It's alright.
I think I know where I can find him.
What are you doing here?
I'm trying to save what's left of us.
Why do I need to be a part of that?
You don't get it, do you, Wesley?
What is there again? I told you I don't want to be a part of this, so just leave me alone.
Wes.
I'm going to tell you this one last time. Stay away from me.
You're the cure, Wesley. Wesley. Wesley!
Yo, Wesley! Get up here, man. Come on.
Oisa, can you quit being an idiot and get down?
Will you quit being a coward? Let's go.
I am not a coward. Now, come on, get down. It's getting late.
Man, this is a part of camping. What did you expect?
Oisa, I'm begging. Can you please just get down?
All right, fine. Only because you said please.
You're an idiot.
Man, shut up. I could tell this isn't your first time camping.
Just shut up. Isn't this your first time camping too?
Well, I mean, I never really found the time for it. We're working all.
Yeah. Elise, I've been meaning to talk to you about that. That doctor, I don't think she's the best person to work for. Based on what you've told me and what she's had you do, I'm just afraid that this line of work is affecting you.
We're trying to help people. What's wrong with that?
All right, look, don't get it twisted. I'm just looking out for you. I've been doing that since the first grade.
Look, the work that we do, some people may not agree with, but it's for the better, and I'm okay with that. I'm fine.
All right, listen. Here's what we're gonna do. Every few years, we're gonna come out to this exact same spot, and we're just gonna get away from it all. All the anger, all the hate, all the evilness in the world. Just the two of us, man.
You're crazy.
Look, I'm serious. Come on, I wouldn't let you down.
Now we're back and we're on the phone with the Dr. C. Diane Colbert.
Colbert.
Ah, yes. Dr. Colbert, it is the season of love out there. What can you tell?
I'm looking to get the message out there that we have a severe epidemic on our hands.
And what exactly is this epidemic?
Well, simply, John, it's killing people. It's a highly contagious virus, which is a ticking time bomb for humanity itself.
Well, Dr. Colbert, no doctor, but that just sounds ridiculous.
Let me be clear. I have been searching for a cure and came very close, but unfortunately, it has not panned out yet. I am looking for more volunteers to be tested at my facility
in North Brunswick.
And I will do my best to save all of you with the data I'm looking to gather. Please contact me.
Well, thank you, Dr. Colbert. I mean, if she really even is a doctor. Sorry about that. Let's kick it back to the commercial-free 70s Top 100 countdown.
How did you even find me?
You don't remember? We said we'd come here every year.
You remembered?
Of course I did. I know you, Wesley. Just like how you know that you need to do this. I've got to take you back to Dr. Colbert.
You can try.
What's wrong with you? What are you trying to do, act tough? Everyone is right about you. You're just a selfish coward. It's over, Wesley! It's over, Wesley! What? It's over!
How much is she even paying you to do all this?
You're crazy if you think I'm doing this for a paycheck.
Oh, give me a break. You've always been the type of person who believes he can do the darkest things and still come out a good man. You still think all this is worth some type of redemption? You're the crazy one, not me.
Do you see what's going to happen to these people? Doing here, man? We went from waiting on phone calls to breaking and entering.
Well, I guess there's only one thing left to do.
Wesley, you know I can't force you to do this.
I know that. That's why I'm not gonna make this any harder for you.
I can
just make the call.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Oh Lord, I've been waiting for this moment for all my life. Oh Lord, oh Lord,
and I can feel it coming.
Dr. Colbert, what I'm about to tell you now is very important. What you may not know is the virus has fully developed and has unfortunately taken the lives of several people. I've called to let you know, and Wesley, that Wesley holds an antibody which could very well lead to the cure. I understand this is hard to hear, and I am aware of the risks, but please understand that this could save the human race. Call me back when you get the message.